Ursinus College Forum. I'm your host, Art Dennis. Last week, we discussed campus date rape and our attitudes towards punishments handed out to such violators. Today, the forum is about campus alcohol policy and the rules pertaining to those violating. How much alcohol can one consume or possess on campus at one time? That's what we're going to tackle today. Let me introduce my guests. To my right, I have Paul Norris. He's our campus, I guess you could call him anti-alcohol person. Beyond that, we have Chloe Maroney. She will give us the female side of alcohol on campus. And finally, we have Joe, Big Joe. He will give us the male's perspective about alcohol on campus. Well, I guess we should just dive into it. We have our first question. I'm going to ask this to all three of you. Do you think there is any difference in the drinking environment due to the banning of kegs, then gallon jugs, and to our present rule of less than 16-ounce containers? Paul, why don't you go first?
Well, Pat, frankly, I see no difference because there's still a lot of drinking going on, and there's a lot more drunk people out there. I mean, you know, the new rules haven't done absolutely nothing except cause people grief. But paying more for cases instead of buying a big old cake. So that's my
interesting viewpoint. Chloe, what's your view?
Well, I don't think it's really changed because people still consume as much alcohol. They just have to go out and buy more cases, and people do that. I mean, instead of having one keg, which is less waste, we have to go out and buy cans now, and so there's waste everywhere. And I don't think it's changed. I mean, I know I, for one, still drink as much, and I mean, and it's just more expensive.
Yeah. Joe, do you feel the same, or is this different?
I agree as well. There's definitely a lot more waste. Usually, I mean, a normal person, on the nights where we had the jugs or the kegs, would have one cup for the entire night, hence less waste. Now it's anywhere from 6 to 24 beers, depending on who that person is. It's a lot more cleanup as well.
Tackling that same question about waste, our science college has recently undergone an environmental awareness campaign, which they're stressing things like recycling, and due to the new alcohol policy banning kegs on campus, do you feel that there is more waste, Paul?
Yes, I do. I work for recycling here on campus, and frankly, I hate those Mondays when I take out the recycling. I mean, boy, that stinks, basically all I have to say, because there's a lot of beer cans, beer bottles, you know, some people might have some hard stuff, and you mix that all up, and if you let that sit for a few days, that gets really stinky, to say technically, and there's a lot more waste. I just see cans all over the place now, and I go to a party in Rybert and hear my feet crunching because I'm stepping on beer cans. It's the waste is intensified.
So you really think that due to the new policy, waste has become, or I guess an accrued stigmata on this campus, right? Okay, Chloe, same?
Yeah, I mean, waste is, it's so much more, and it's not just like the environmental aspect, it's the fact that I live in Reimert, and like I go outside of Reimert, you know, I go out after parties on Saturday, whatever, the next morning, and it's just like disgusting. It's cans and stuff everywhere, and then it leads to bugs, and it smells gross. It just, it makes it, I mean, it really takes away the beauty from the campus. It really does.
Yeah. Going back to the actual alcohol policy, why do you think faculty, more or less, why do you think they believe that having kegs banned and making cans the new, I guess, focal point around drinking, why do you think they believe that that means less consumption?
Well, I don't know the price of cases, because frankly I don't buy those, but from what I've heard from my friends and all that, I hear cases are more, and if you buy a big keg, it's going to cost less in the long run instead of buying cases upon cases of beer. And I guess it's the administration's understanding that the more money it costs to buy beer, the less beer that will actually be bought. But then again, the price of college keeps going up and we keep coming here, so I frankly don't see their reasoning in that.
Trends are trends then, huh?
Yeah.
Chloe, your feelings?
Could you repeat that question, please?
Why do you think administration believes that banning kegs will reduce the amount of alcohol consumption on campus?
Oh, well, I totally think it's that same exact reason. I mean, they think that we're going to drink less because it costs more to buy cases. But, I mean, it doesn't matter because if you want to drink, you're going to drink. And if you want to have parties, you're going to have parties and you're going to buy it anyway. You know what I mean? And I mean, that's what I honestly believe, that they just think that we won't because it costs more.
Okay. Joe, real quick, are you basically the same?
Basically the same.
Okay, well, I want to thank you all for coming out today. We want to, you know, hope this stirs up more, debates over the present alcohol policy. And hopefully someday soon, these can be amended. Mark Guinness, thank you for coming to our Ursinus College Forum. Have a good night.